You want to say hello to the people?
Hello.
Okay. So go ahead, do your thing. It shouldn't take that long, but yeah, let's see what you got going on. That it is kid friendly. Go ahead, do your thing. Yeah, make sure everything is shaken up really well. All right, let's see what color scheme. Let me put this back here. This needs another coat. I may put another coat on. Yeah, make sure you press that water really good into that brush. Make sure that the whole brush is saturated and then you dry it out. It just seems like it helps blend the paint better, but you do not want it dripping. So come on and just dab. Just dab, press it in there. You dab and you lift and it should be ready to go. So it's wet and it'll do its thing. Okay, well, mama's going back off now. Go ahead and just squeeze it on out here, and that way you can just go ahead and just hit it. Mm-hmm. And then you can add more as you need to. Yep. All right. And keep that first coat thin. Spread it, because you know you'll probably need two, maybe three coats. All right. And while you got like a lot on there, I'm going to tell you, like painter's cut in the corner, I'm going to tell you why you got like a lot on your brush to kind of come right on around the edge. Mm-hmm. Kind of dip in there because you can mess around a little bit. Spread it a little bit so you can, just spread what you have on here like this. Make sure you got enough on there that will help you kind of cut on around there. And you see you're going to probably have to dip and get a little bit more. So while you get along there, and then you can just and make sure you hit the edges while you're working too. Okay, so you're going to need a little bit more, or you can dip in what you have out there, spread it all out. Mm-hmm. Okay, yep. And then don't worry if it goes in there, because you're going to do another coat, and you can finish it up with whatever you're going to do. So you kind of keep it moving. Okay. And turn it how you need to angle it. Mm-hmm. And then just come on and hit and spread all that up out of there. Awesome. Before this starts drying and getting gummy, go ahead and spread all that out. Go ahead and get rid of that paint. You can add more, and then the excess is where you brush it along the edges. There you go, babe. Mm-hmm. Keep it thin. Yep. There you go. And while you have a little bit, you can cut it while you're over there a little bit too, while you're up in that area. And then don't be afraid to twist the painting as you need to get up in there too. There you go. Thank you for being my mother and
giving me the book that I adapted Hi. Don't know who you are. Say hello if you have a moment. Cool. Now, while you got enough on your brush, cut it. And if you need to twist your painting upside down so that you can go along that line. Now, it's different if you're painting a mural on the wall. It is what it is. But when you have this painting and you can move it, do so. There you go. There you go. Hello there. There you go. And don't worry about that eyelash, because you can come right back over it with, There you go. Coolness. Yep, because you see while it's kind of generous in there, then it's easy to go around. And you might have to cut it with a smaller brush, but sometimes with that straight edge, I kind of like it. There you go. And while you got that, But be careful when you go along that black line. You want to be as careful as you can. And then, as you get a little bit further away from it, then you can kind of be a little bit more free. Like near the edge of that painting back over there, where the white is. Yep. Go ahead and fill that in. There you go. Exactly. But be careful when you get close to the face or the head. Cool. Go back and smooth all that out. Hit the edge. You might be able to do three edges. Not the edge for the painting. The actual side of the painting. Yep, go ahead and get that done and out of the way. Cool. Yeah, don't even try to be cute with it. Just come on and hit it. Yeah, it's the side. Blend it in. And go back and hit that empty white spot down there, because you want it all to be covered, and then when the next layer goes on, it'll stick a little bit better. And in this seam, and I can't do it real well, in that seam, hit inside of that corner. And you might have to take that brush and press it in there. There you go. And do the bottom seam too. While you're on this side, get that first coat. Let me set this back up. Nope, don't worry about that right now. I need you to make sure you're hitting all of this. Get into that seam. You might have to scrape, you know, kind of drop that in there. Make sure this is good and smooth. You just want a good solid coat on it, and then you want to leave it alone. So you can do maybe three sides, and then come back. I wouldn't worry about trying to make sure you get into that, because it all needs a good coat. Okay. Get along the edge, because like I said, it just helps the next coat stick to it. And I guess that's where, you know how you talked about putting stuff out on the plate? That's a little rock. Why is my little rock stuck in here? So I'm going to go ahead and squeeze a little bit of this purple out. So there you go. And I guess everybody wants to get the colored brushes, thinking that the color is supposed to be super cute. Get the brush that works the best. Now go back over and fill in all of those holes. Cool. Do you need me to plug in the dryer?
And so while that's drying, but I'd smooth this out. Smooth that out a little bit right fast. Can you see how that paint picks back up? Some of it is dry, some of it. And I know sometimes, a lot of times when people are painting, they just keep going over and over. Just leave it alone, let it dry, because it's just gonna pick up. Let it dry, put another coat on, and we can rock and roll with that. So now, what color are you gonna put in here?
Black.
I'm just gonna say it's gonna be a whole lot of black. The face, I can understand black. I don't know, what other color does this special person like? Because when you talked about the purple background, I thought, yeah, the purple and the gold would be nice, and then you still have the black silhouette face. Get the black on the face and then maybe decide. Okay? You might want to go with a slightly smaller brush. You ready to hit it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then don't worry if you lose the earring, because we can do the earring with a circle template cup something at the end. All right. So okay, I would just. Yep, just a little bit. And it looks kind of like polka dot a little bit. That's kind of cool too. Cool. And if you think that you're losing control with that brush, you might have to go a size down. And don't worry about the white. Come on in, and while you got enough paint on it, cut that edge. Turn it. Nope. Don't paint out of control. Turn it so that you can still retain control. Turn the painting however it's easiest for you, so that that brush doesn't start going out of the blinds, because then it starts looking messy and bad, and you don't want that. So that's what I'm saying. Turn the actual whole painting. And if it's starting to get out of control, then you might have to get a smaller brush. But do the big areas while you can. Go ahead and cover up all the big areas. And then you can come back with a smaller brush to go along the edges. Okay? I'm trying to tell you. You got all of this area out here. Yep, all of that big area out there, and then get a smaller brush to go along the details, because you don't want to start losing control. And I kind of like that little white left on that nose. It's kind of like a little highlight. This is where Bob Ross talks about those happy accidents. Pick the painting up, baby. Pick it up and turn it so that you can be in control. Get a smaller brush. Stop now, because you're going to go outside of the lines, because the brush now is too big. Wait, hold it. Get in here, like I say, the large areas. Get the large areas. And then when it starts to get along the edge, then you go for a slightly smaller brush. All right, so here we are. Let me turn it. There we go.
Hey there. How are you, Lady J? We got somebody we experiment on. I hope you enjoyed going downtown yesterday.
Yes.
Yes, pray for the mother, but she's a sweetheart, though. So pray for the mama with teenager. What a girlfriend, but yeah, she doesn't follow me. Not yet. It's looking good. Let me get a little bit closer so we can see. Look at that highlight on that nose. That's a happy accident, but he might need to keep it because the purple is going to be a little bit dark. He was thinking about doing the whole silhouette black and just popping the earring with gold. I don't know. It's a look. Okay, I gotcha. Twist the painting, baby, so that you can get in the angles that you need to. Don't sit there and fight with it when all you have to do is simply shift it, turn it all the way around, turn it all the way so that you're still in control of that paint. Because like I say, if we're painting a wall, we can't turn the wall. But this painting right here, you could turn it and twist it. Always up for some gold. Ah, that is cool. You see the one back there in the background? I need to do another coat. So, I like it because you can flip it and turn it the other way for the silhouette painting heading, pointing to the right as well. All right, once you do that, smooth out some of those super wet areas and then let it dry. Because the background now might be ready for a little bit, but then that fourth side of the painting is also now ready for a little bit of paint. Let me put this back up over here. Let me see. Yeah, he gonna paint me in a minute, but I'm guiding. I'm not fussing. I'm giving painterly tips as we go along. Okay. You know what? The white in the background can be their choice. Or, you know, of course, they can choose to color it any way they want. I just thought the black and the gold and the white was a look all by itself. And of course, yes, people are free. Like this one chose to do the purple, honey. Yes, it depends on, of course, your decor. That's why it's the painted pose. Own your walls. You own your walls. You own them. So what is it that you want in your space? Yep, that's the Malachi look. Pat Jones says she loved that expression. Get back to work, young man. Get back to work. Get back to work. Turn it so the camera can see right quick what's going on. And explain what you're about to do.
I'm about to go over on the top here with just finish this side right here. And then I'm gonna let the black dry before I get kind of too close to the face, but I'm just gonna go around it, give it another coat.
Honey, I still love that little pop of white on that nose, even though that was not intentional. That is working for me. So you thinking you're gonna go ahead and do the whole thing black?
I like the little white pop out right here, mm-hmm. But I think I just wanna turn that gold, okay. And then have this go, or I think.
Well, did you want to try it all black? I mean, it can be all black if that's your idea. I don't want to sway you from it. But when you first told me that you're going to do purple background, I thought it was with the gold. But it doesn't have to be. You can do what you think that she'd like. I don't know who's over there singing, but there we are. Mm-hmm. We're with the Oscars. Well, we're going to do a hyperlapse in here as well. Just so, but I thought we would go live because I just hadn't done anything live in a minute. And we're about to get out of this
comfort zone. We'll get back to this. We'll get back to the the hair and the earring.
Well, it's really like a head wrap, scarf wrap.
The head wrap.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like hair, but
It could be an updo. It could be a poofy, you know.
Mm-hmm. Updo. We'll get back to
it. Okay, that's fine. So here's some more purple that's ready to go. And you got all the water out of your brush.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Cool. Yay. I am ready to eat. I don't know why I didn't eat before we started painting, but the mama is going to be back here munching. Hello, welcome, welcome. There we go. Just keep it thin. Because like I say, you can go back and do another coat. You see where that is already... That second coat on that part makes a difference. Mm-hmm. It just clings. Take your time, Mal. Don't be rushed. If it's a wrap, it could also be multicolored. Yes, it could be. That's why I love the simplicity of the design. And you could take it anywhere. Flip it to the camera. You could take it any which way you want it to go. That's why I love that simple design. It's not too big, not too small. That's why it... Oh, Afrocentric colors? Yes, it sure could be. Hello to whoever else is there. Say it again.
Wakanda forever.
Yeah, it could be. All right, do your thing. Do your thing, sir. I'm just helping you as far as like the painting technique. Now, the color choice is yours. That's why it's like to make it easier... Twist it. You know, if you need to twist it upside down to get up in there, do that. But as far as the color choice, knock yourself out.
So, just adding another coat around it.
You definitely need to go ahead and do another coat. Unless you like this particular streaky style. Some people
I'm going to give like it one more coat and see from there.
Yeah. I would probably do another coat. Go ahead and hit it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Go ahead and hit it and cut around the face. Yeah, I think that will work. Mm-hmm. And then add more as you need it. But remember, while you have like an abundance of paint in your brush, that's when you cut it. And be careful. That'll help you stay in control. Hi there, Melissa Mullins. Let me show you this dude. Look at the dude. Look up at the camera, dude. Because this is Facebook. And this is Melissa Mullins from 44. Back in the day. Awesome. Now, Pat Jones was saying she liked the texture in the purple. But it just also depends on, you know, your style. Cut it would mean like, you know, in the corner of a wall. You know how painters cut the edges? Mm-hmm. He needs to cut the edges along the actual silhouette. And when you've got enough paint in your brush, it's easier to do because you're kind of pushing the paint along. Let me see this right quick. You don't have enough paint in your brush, babe. That's what I'm saying. You need to have like an abundance so that you can get in here and you're just kind of pushing that paint along and you're cutting along that edge. And then you can go wild out here. But along that edge, you're babying it. And like I say, if that brush is too large for that, then get a slightly smaller brush. So now this is about to flatten out over here. It is interesting with the texture. Cool. Yep, and twist it so that you can stay in control. Yep, right now I would worry about cutting it along that edge, and then you can hit that outline. Hello, precious lady. Hello, Riverside 44. Cool. Now pop on the camera. Here's another 44 teacher, ma'am. Child, who this? Cool. All right. Cool. Hold it up for the camera. Just quick, and then you can go right on back to work. And I need to probably take pictures as you're working, but oh well. Cool. He's got a girlfriend. Pray for me.
Mama, I can hear you.
No, you can't. And like I say, if that spot is like, you know what, I better go for a smaller brush, go for a smaller brush and keep it moving. Yay! Refrigerator and get me some rotisserie chicken, baby. I'm gonna go sit over here on this couch and let dude do his thing. But yes, just to give him some pointers, because he hasn't painted anything in a long time. This is one of his paintings back here. This is one of his. I love it. I love it. So he hasn't done anything in a while. But he should do it more often. So I'm glad that, you know, Valentine's Day is inspiring him to paint for. What is the look for? What is the look for? What is the look for?
Thanks,
what is the look for? I'm glad Valentine's Day is inspiring the art to come out. So it's a creative gift that I think she will appreciate. She is a sweet young lady, so I don't mind standing here coaching on her behalf. Yes, Pat Jones was saying that you need to be about the business of your gift as far as creating, you know. It could be a mama baby, mama son type of thing. I'm not against any of that. Let me make sure my flowers are in the shot. There we go. There we go. Oh, Pat Jones says love can make all, you know, things come out of you. Yep. We'll see. He want to do Mal, yeah. He doesn't have to paint with me, but he needs to paint maybe more often. Because since he was, I don't know, a little toddler, you know, I used to have a little shelf
set aside long time ago when we were in the apartment that he had his markers, colored pencils, crayons, and he had a little his little watercolor set, and he had a little cup that my godmother gave to him. And then I could hear him drag his little steps to drag his step stool up. He would drag his little step stool up to the sink in the bathroom, go fill up his little cup, put it down on his table, he'd get his paint and everything out. He would paint maybe for 2 minutes. Oh Lord, that is hilarious. I hadn't thought about that in a minute. But yep, he would have his Play-Doh, his markers, his colored pencils, his paint, his crayons, all of that was there for him. Let me move this out of the way. Cool. Now, if it's wet and you've already hit it, leave it alone so it can dry, because you're going to keep picking it up. I would hit this top part one more time while you got enough paint in here. Cool. Be careful if the sides are wet.
You're not gonna be laughing. You're not gonna be laughing at this artist. He had his own style, baby. I tell you, it was just, and you know, as a mom, all you could do was just, you know, smile. The child got up in there and painted. And you know, it was just funny. It was funny. Yes. He's about to hit that now. So it's coming along. Baby, now he done gave me an idea. I think I am going to make sure I leave me a little highlight on the nose and maybe on the lips when I do another one. And like I say, on mine back over there, I did not. Oh yeah, he got it. Don't do another coat, babe. Let the stuff dry, because you're gonna lift up what you've already put down there. So let that part dry. Go to the next part. Let me get over here. So it looks like maybe the black needs another coat. And I think 2 coats will probably do it. Let me see. Oscars are still playing in the background. All right. Well, this is fun. We need to do this more often. Need to do it more often. It is fun. Highlight in the forehead, yeah. I will see. I just might leave it simple. Be careful about, yeah, push it, yeah. Where you know you've got enough control, push it, pull it, however you can stay in control of the paint. I would pick this whole thing up and turn it all the way around. Turn it all the way so you can get up in there and be control. Since you're right-handed, I would be in control of the paint. Okay.
I don't know what just happened.
We will blurt that out of the video. I have no idea, but just keep moving while you got that black.
Oh, I'm sorry, everybody.
No, that's okay.
Let me get over here. Let me get over here and eat something, because, child, I don't know why all of a sudden it feels like I haven't eaten in 8 days, but I'm going to eat while you're painting. I would love to have some music playing in the background, but Facebook will cut you off in a minute. Let me see, Pat Jones still there. Signing off. Enjoy your day, babe. And you're going to have to go live when you're creating too, babe. Now, who knows? Sometimes a live doesn't give good reception. So I don't know. It looks fine, but it may be pixelated later. So sometimes it's good just to record and then upload. But, you know, we're just taking a chance. Girl, go to bed. Love you, Pat Jones. Lady J, see you later.
I didn't even know we were still live.
Yeah, we're still live.
The way it sounded like you're signing us off.
I was reading what she had already said. She was signing off. Keep going. And from time to time, you might need to hold it up towards the camera. You know, let me zoom up over up in there. Okay. It's coming. Ah, gotcha.
In time, I trust you will come to regard me with affection.
I'm seeing a cut of my own throat.
That would be a shame. It's rather a pretty throat. But at least my little laugh can be married.
You might need to add a little bit more purple around the edges.
Our father entrusted her to my care. The man saved my life, and in return, I failed to honor the one thing that he asked of me.
Still, there's no use dwelling on it. What's done is done.
How can a man begin to make amends till he's willing to face his own fault? That's why he came to London.
Look at
You know who that is?
No.
That's Eminem. So the Grammys is for the music greats, the Oscars is for the movie greats. And let me say, I think the Emmys are TV or theater. Maybe both. I gotta look that up. So you might only be able to do two sides, or maybe three, and then come back to the other. So how are you feeling about it?
Really good.
You think it's still going to be a good idea, gift?
Well.
So you think it's still going to be a good gift?
Yes.
I don't know our signal. Cool. So, what is that, like the second coat back on there?
One, two.
Yeah. Okay. And like I said, some areas might need a third. Let me see what's shaping up here. Something about that little piece of highlight on that nose that rots. So it's coming along. Go out there? So what you about to do now? Because like I say, if need be, you can do the hair dryer. But this is, unless you're just going to go ahead with your brush and kind of touch up a few areas that you see, you know, that might need a... That white is still kind of nice up there. That one slice of nutty cheese at the bottom, and another drape haphazardly over the 100% fresh beef patty cooked right when you order. True, the hottest juice. I don't think the black would be a bad idea, like you originally said.
Yeah, I think I was gonna have it all black.
Mm-hmm. With a little papa.
With the little papa.
Okay.
No.
Yep, you say that at the very end. Yep, and then you, a little bit will go a long way. Mm-hmm, yep.
I just wanted to make sure it's close.
Right.
And I wanted to make sure that was the same texture of gold.
Right, that's the same gold.
And I didn't want to use a yellow that was like golden yellow.
Right, so just a little bit.
I want to make sure it was a metallic gold.
Right, that's the metallic gold there. So, come on and go ahead and hit it. That way, because I'm not sure how long we've been on camera. That's when the amount of virus is so low, it can't be measured by labs. Go ahead. Research shows people who take HIV treatment every day and get... Just press. You don't have to keep dabbing. If you just press and hold it, the water is going to be sucked up out of there. You want it? Rare life-threatening side effects include a buildup of lactic acid and liver problems. Do not take Biktarvy if you take dofetilide or rifampin. Tell your doctor about all the medicines. Let me get a good view of that.
That's kind of funky and a little cool at the same time. I should have been doing screenshots while you were working on it. Ah! Ah, why won't it let me do it? How come I can't? Oh, because I'm hitting the wrong button. There we go. Okay, let me do it again. Because I had the words and everything all on the screen, too.
Whether it's the one you start out with.
You may now kiss your husband.
Cool. That's kind of fun and funky. And be ready to twist and turn as you go along the edges. And the good thing is, while you've got a lot of paint on there, that's when you cut the edge. So do you want to leave a little bit of this, or are you going to maybe go around here maybe with a little gold possibly? Maybe not. Maybe not.
Yeah, I'm okay. Just going to mix.
And I don't want this to knock off, so they move this over here. Be careful, because you're going backwards. You will have more control going that way. Because if you go backwards, you'll lose control, I think, a little bit faster. But since you're right-handed, and you're pulling and pushing the paint along that way, I think you'll have better control. That's what I mean.
The seemingly impossible task of sound editors is to immerse the viewer in a world they and we have likely never heard firsthand.
This year's nominees.
Yeah, but you got to be careful, and if you got to twist it as you do it, then pick it up and twist. Yep, so that you can stay in control. That's the whole point.
Here are the nominees for achievement in sound editing. Ford versus Ferrari, Donald Sylvester. Joker, Alan
for achievement in sound mixing.
there is a blue there. Spread that out.
Say it again.
So I spread that out.
Spread what out?
Like just the front right here.
Nope. Nope. Let it just dry like it is. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Because I think by now we probably would have thought about that earlier because it has like a skin on it now and it probably start looking like a mistake. You know what I'm saying? So now it'll look like it's part of the actual paint. You know, next time keep it thin. If it's like too much paint, wipe it off. You know, so it can be flat unless you want to use texture on purpose. So are there some areas that you know you might need to touch up while that part is drying? Oh yeah, we need to put over here.
And you might want to go in here with a little black, with a little, and use a good brush.
That'll come to a good tip. And just use just a little bit at a time. And sometimes I put my little pinky finger down here. I don't have a lot of paint on there, so I might have to dip a little bit more often. So I got a little bit more paint this time, so I can push it. I'm going right back. Because it wasn't not necessarily the most round, perfect thing I've ever done in my whole entire life. Let me see. So that might be a little bit of purple up in there. You know, how you just fill it all in and that should be a little bit purple.
I just filled it all in.
You need to get some purple because that's part of the chin, you know?
I thought, oh.
Yeah, that's part of that chin.
Yeah, I see it.
Yeah.
So this is still going to be wet a little bit here. I'm just going to go ahead and hit that.
Ancestors, watch over my daughter Melon. If her identity is discovered, she will be killed.
Take over.
impossible. Yeah, you're gonna have to get a little bit of purple and going on up in there. Why you got a little bit of black on here? I put my thumb, my pinky down, and I'll kind of maybe dab it just a little bit. You know, you can just find some of the edges there, clean that up, and then go back in and definitely get that purple.
Stay tuned for more about Sanditon, but first...
The funny thing is, the food is absolutely amazing. This is secret sauce. How come you didn't teach me? It's a city that constantly is growing, and then you have this China thousand. Your food is so good. It's unfair.
We have a traditional Taiwan food.
Mongolian hot pot.
Taiwanese chicken.
Tangful noodles.
Tangful noodles. Nice.
Okay. Perfect. There we go.
No passport required. Tune in or stream tomorrow at 9 and Central, only on PBS.
Next time, on Sanditon.
I fear she will not see out the night.
There never was a well. There most certainly was a night.
Tom, Mrs. Campion?
I convinced myself that I'm well suited for matrimony.
I suppose it's just a question of compatibility.
Sanditon, next time, on Masterpiece. Coming soon on Masterpiece.
You're aware you are just a skin in the sea.
Go over the this side right here.
For all of that, there's a darker side.
This is a bigger brush.
Men can be so artful in their persuasion.
Yeah, just because it's like not an area that you need to be super careful with. Just kind of get it on there. But, you know, and you're slapping it on.
I think it's
going to
be a little western to it.
Right.
The other edges before you get started, so you know what it is that you're doing.
It's a conflict between good and evil. It's got characters that want the best and characters that want the worst.
You are an English baronet. I am well aware that you have so far frittered away these advantages and used them in pursuit of petty conquests and the sowing of wild oats. I do not.
Jane Austen, we think of her as very genteel, but often in the subplots, there's underage sex, there are elopements, there are seductions, there are betrayals, there are teenage pregnancies. Really, all those things happen in Sense and Sensibility, but people tend to forget about them somehow. Deep down, the core of the story is nearly always about sex and money. Sometimes you would be inclined to say love rather than sex. With Pride and Prejudice, it is clearly sex. The driving engine of the plot is Darcy's sexual desire for Elizabeth. And she's rude to him, and he keeps coming back for more. He doesn't understand what's happening to him, but we do. It's the great pull, it's the selfish gene. It's biology.
The wonderful thing about this story is that the women really do hold a lot of the power.
Earl Barrington. I wondered when he'd come sniffing around.
Shall I have the pleasure of seeing you, Lady Dillon's luncheon party?
I suppose.
I shall put off you.
It comes across as quite nasty. You start to realise that it's just pure honesty. She's just telling the truth about how she feels about people.
I'm starting to find you slightly better company.
I've never met anyone else who could give a compliment in such a way as it might also be an insult. You are extraordinary.
I know you think of me often.
You flatter yourself.
What Clara does is she observes quietly, and then she tries to find their weakness.
Hold it for the camera.
With Edward, his weakness is his desire for women, and Clara knows that she can use that.
I feel like I'm glad you did do it, you know.
It's the deadly sin, isn't it?
And then the next time, instead of using the flat paint, we can actually get the artist paint, you know, that squeezed out of the tube, and then that will definitely give you texture. And then maybe I might have you go over with just a little bit of white. Just a poop.
National funding for masterpiece is
provided. Pop that accent. And when you squeeze out, you don't have to squeeze out a lot. Just a little dab will do you. So you found that chin.
Do you want to go check in the bathroom to make sure, you know, how you hold the art, how I tell people to hold the artwork up? Or you might hold it up right over here.
All right, I will.
Okay. So while you were painting, did you hit this bottom edge? This is why I told you.
No, because it looks...
Well...
Oh, I see, I see.
That's what I'm saying. I want you to check while you were doing another fold over there. Check the other ones. Because see, there's some white here. Yeah, you want to make sure. Mm-hmm. You want to finish that part off. And that's part of the craftsmanship of it, you know?
Kevin, how's your mom?
Life well planned. Learn more at RaymondJeans.com.
Because if it's just something quick and fast that you really don't care anything about, but since it's a gift, take that extra moment. And like if I was painting this for someone, I would make sure all of that is in place. And don't keep it thick, because you can always do another quick coat if need be.
And by viewers like you.
Cool.
Thank you.
And then like I say, I would just kind of check right along here on this edge too. But see, you want to make sure that white is covered.
Go to our website.
Because if she doesn't put it in the frame,
to order this program or related,
you won't have to worry about it because it's already been taken care of.
PDS Passport and on Amazon Prime Video.
Make sure that that fold around that corner is handled. And you got to look because it's a canvas. It's got some texture to it, so you want to make sure that the little dot or white isn't in. I can see myself being knocked out with an elbow.
Whoa, that's what you can't do.
Let me get out the way. And it's all live on camera. Didn't mean to knock you upside the head, woman. Some of the white paint was shining through, or
want to watch Antiques Roadshow?
I would probably do one more.
Check out Antiques Roadshow recap.
That's just part of the process.
Hi there. It's current.
Monday,
yep.
7:30. It was just something that you were just throwing around, doing whatever, but if it's a gift, take that extra care.
might sound weird, but I'd follow you anywhere in a non-creepy way.
Mm-hmm. I'll be one of them unless they're Quibi. Go!
It's durable too, with top grade leather on a wooden metal frame, and it spoils you with everything you need right within reach.
Yeah, sometimes you have to wait till everything dries real well, because yeah, that's going to take a moment.
We are Value City Furniture, and we're going to be your new favorite furniture store.
To pop that lip out a little bit more. You can also do that with a marker. So you ready to do the gold?
My creamy dreamy citrus will be crazy good on those fish tacos. Real lime, real cilantro. Am I right?
Mm, oh yeah.
You know what we're gonna need?
What?
More tacos.
I don't have any more.
Indulge in the taste of Tessie Mae's. Real ingredients and flavor you can't ignore.
So yes, the delicate.
Wait. Once you take that bite, you can't.
Area going around the silhouette. The contour lines, the contoured edge. Along this large shape around that perimeter. You can do it with marker as well. It just adds to like the character. So I would squeeze out a very minimal amount, and this is too much white.
Yep,
too much white. Just squeeze out just a little bit because the paint goes a little bit further than what most people think.
See, what I'm looking at mine, and then what I'm looking at yours, mine looked like her mouth is open a little bit, if you can see it.
Yeah.
And yours looked like her mouth is closed.
Yeah. But, I mean, do we want it to be open? Because we want it to be in proportion. We don't want the lips to be too small or too large. We want it to be.
So, how would.
As cast members of the motion picture cast.
You want me to do it with paint?
Which one would be better, the marker?
Understands the importance of good visual effects. Here are the nominees for achievement in visual effects.
Avengers Endgame.
Dead.
Mm-hmm.
Russell Earl. Matt Aitken. Yeah, and they can go a little bit more, you know, if need be.
Pablo Hellman.
Okay.
Leandro Estebecarena.
So what are you going to do? Clean up the edge around?
I think if you would make it a little bit more.
A little bit more?
Andrew R. Jones and Elliot Newman. 1917.
You might go in here and clean up some of this as far as the, come on around here. And you can go back in there with that purple.
And Dominic Tui.
Uh-oh. I don't know what they're doing. That is crazy.
I'm the Oscar girl.
These folks are crazy. That's funny. So I'm going to come in here. Because it doesn't have to be super thick. So you can get the white paint and then maybe make this more of a curve. But I would hold it up in the mirror just to... Honey, I'm going to need my glasses on. So you can hit that with that purple there. But I would come along here with a little bit of white paint.
Thank you, Bobby. I'm having the most tremendous honor.
Before I go over it with the gold.
But, an opportunity to challenge how we approach visual effects, but also a chance to collaborate with some truly fantastic
people. Just a little bit of white on that nose.
Thank you to Sam Mendes for being so inspirational and leading us through, you know, this epic journey. I want to thank
our producers. Look in the mirror and see about the curve of the earring.
Everybody attending and
Universal. I think that's coming along nice.
Thank you to my beautiful wife, Kate, for standing right by me in every step of the way.
It's something, and just something slightly off. And you know I'm not Leslie the brushes in the water girl.
We share this award with you. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you so much. All the kids at home. Thank you the team. Thank you.
Thank you.
Situation.
Our transformation starts in the makeup and hair trailer.
All joking aside, I just want to say I saw firsthand how talented hair and makeup people are. The Irishman, they would transform us every day.
Man, keep it thin. Don't make it thick. It's a small. Baby, you got the wrong brush. That's why I'm going over here to clean that out. You need a fine tip brush. You got there.
Everyone woke up there.
Well, Mossy, you could run right to the sink. Clean that out. Put my water right now. It's clean. Well, I didn't know that you were about to get started on the right thing if you don't have the right brush. Because I knew I didn't see this brush here, so I figured it was in here, so that's why I wanted to go clean it out. Yep, you want something with a very fine tip because you're doing a very fine, intricate thing. So I'm going to, this is where you need like a Q-tip. Because I'm just going to go lift this up right here. Just to, so it's not so thick. Just, and then before you touch it on there. Stick it in there and then just tap it in just a little bit so that you can make sure you have super fine tip. And then make sure you're going in the correct, you know, direction so that you're in control.
Thank you very much. It's a great honor. And we would like to thank members of Academy and Director J-Watch and Charles Landolf, Bob Grab, Karen Gritchell, Beth Connell, AJ Dix, Michelle Blanc, and Dave Johnson, and the entire team at Bronze Studio and Live Skit. And the cast and crew and friends and family for their amazing support. And my mentors, Rick Baker and Dick Smith. And we would like to give our heartfelt thanks to Sherry.
Well, let me just say this right here. If you're coming down and you know you need to be up here, start up here and then come down because then it's going to be wet, you know, unless you're going to twist it and turn it, you know.
And because of your bravery and passion, we are able to set the new bar in the makeup industry and create a new way to tell stories. Thank you very much. And we wouldn't be getting this award without you.
turn it so you have ultimate control. And I think you keep fighting with it instead of knowing how your hand is going to move and knowing how that paint is going to move, that you're in control. Make sure it's not thick now. You don't want it to be thick. Fix that curve out there.
This is just for us.
Mm-hmm. And hold it like you would hold writing. Don't touch that because that's still wet. Yeah, that's why it's like you got to be conscious. Put that thumb, that pinky down like I told you. That'll help give you a little bit of stability. Look, see, I'm not putting the pinky down to be cute. I'm putting the pinky down for stability. Fingernail is on there. It might have to do a couple coats of it. Right in here. Cool.
Feature film from Poland, Corpus Christi, directed by Jan Komasa.
Okay.
I then support the new direction that this change symbolizes.
Sometimes what I'll do, I'll wet it, and I'll wipe off most of the paint out there to keep the water clearer. Mm-hmm. But it just depends. Everybody does a little bit different. Some will hold it in the bathroom mirror because it's nice, bright light. Look at it, see what else you might need to do. And if you're going to add a little bit more purple around the back, I'm going to add. That's fine, baby. You don't have to do that tonight. But I'm maybe we'll definitely know on this side.
Hi there. He's gonna go check the painting in the bathroom mirror.
Mm-hmm. I'm just looking. I looked at it in the mirror. And I'm looking at it from this mirror.
Mm-hmm.
The little white on the black.
Yeah.
It's just talking to me.
Right.
And I'm trying to think if I wanted to turn that to gold, just leave it like this. But I think I really do want to turn it to gold.
You might want to. Ooh, let me get that little piece of punk out of there. You might want to. Cause it won't be hard to turn back.
Mama doing hers that she's kind of touching up.
Mm-hmm.
With that little layer. With the gold. Oh, it's only 10:31?
What do you mean only? Child, this day is over.
But, like, it doesn't feel like it's 10:31. It feels like he's 8:31. Mm-hmm.
Right. That's what happens when you start to create.
And that's what happens when you start doing it for some, like, for a reason. It's like, it may just feel like you want to create, so it's just like an urge to create.
Mm-hmm. I just made that a little bit thicker back there. Alright, I'm gonna leave it alone. Let me see, I might still have it too blown out. Ah, there we go. Okay, there we are. Cool. So now, I'm gonna set mine up over here so you can finish. Try to put it on thick. It's okay if you do five coats, you know what I'm saying?
Everyone has a story to tell. You know,
baby, I'll always just take your time. Don't force it. When you feel that that paint is running out, just go and dab and get a little bit more.
Finding their way through extraordinary circumstances.
Oh, you're cash only?
Yes, there's an ATM next door.
Right, but the fees.
Actually, with the BMO Harris Smart Advantage account, you don't pay fees at over 40,000 ATMs nationwide.
Surely there's a monthly fee. The universe is connected by monthly fees.
Not if you go with paperless statements. And in this universe, there's no minimum balance either.
My wisdom rock, you should have it.
Oh, I already got one.
Whoa. Oh. That feeling you get when you can bank without fees? That's the BMO effect.
At Ball State University, we are empowered to seek new insights, unrestrained.
And let me know when you get ready to shift, because I got it zoomed in.
Spread our wings and fly. Lifted by knowledge, enabled across disciplines, we are inspired, engaged, and exhilarated. Propelled to change the world. And with beneficence as our guide, at Ball State University.
Then people wonder why it costs so much, because I can almost see coming around there with just like a little red to pop it, a little bit of green to pop it around the edges.
Please welcome.
You know how I outlined it over here just a little bit? I've got like a little purple, and I got like a little bit of red just to pop it. But you don't have to do that with yours. I might have to do that
with mine.
Alright, I'm about to turn it on.
Of the Tonga, the Tatavian, and the Chumash. We acknowledge them as the first peoples of this land on which our motion picture community lives and works. Mariora. And now it is my honor to recognize this past year's recipients at the Governor's Awards.
I'm ready to lay down now.
Honorary Oscars were presented to actor Wes Studi. And directors David Lynch and Lena Wertmüller. The Jean Hersholm Humanitarian Award went to actress Gina Davis. And for us tonight, our West Studio and Gina Davis.
Right there.
And now, please welcome Gal Gadot, Academy Award nominated actress Sigourney Weaver, and Academy Award winner Brie Larson.
I'm about to turn it on.
Mm-hmm. It is an absolute honor to stand beside my fellow superhero gal and the woman who paved the way for us, Sigourney Weaver.
Yes. And I might take the highlight. The white, I might make it just a little smaller.
It's such an honor to be standing here with you.
Gosh. Yeah, the three of us make a powerful combination. And in fact, just now backstage, we decided that after the show, we're going to start a fight club. And if anyone wants in,
men are all invited, but no shirts allowed.
Yeah, I'm sorry, just a Hollywood guy.
Lifetime supply of deodorant, sushi, and tequila.
Yeah,
and the loser gets to answer questions from journalists about how it feels to be a woman in Hollywood.
Yes.
Don't go over it anymore. Let it dry. Yeah, hey, let it dry in between coats. Because then you're just going to be picking the paint up and making it kind of gummy and tacky and, yeah, just let it dry, and then maybe in the morning you might come and hit it.
Definitely.
You know, maybe three times before you go, because it doesn't take long. Let's find the containers to put that in. Probably we'll call this a wrap. Can we do a video over here? Yeah, we're gonna call this a wrap. And I want to do like a big picture with lips. Is this true?
Okay. I'm seeing it from the camera view. Yeah. It's
coming along.
Okay. The gold really does pop.
Mm-hmm. It's a nice metallic. Let me see. That is... I'll put it on the camera so people can know. So, you just preserve it. I don't know where my spritz bottle is. What I'm going to do, I'm going to take one of these paper towels, kind of wet it a little bit, and put it in here. That's like a little moisture guarantee. Seal that up, and this is right here in the morning for you before you go off to school. So this is Sargent acrylic metallic. I kind of like the way that looks over some of the others. I know I still have a couple more to try out, but this is what this is here. It looks pretty good. So I guess this is about 2 hours later. That's his result.
I think it turned out pretty nice. I think his girlfriend will be pleased.
Nice.
Oh, okay. So you want to hold it on camera? And then the Oscar music is playing in the background. Let's see. I don't know who that guy is back there. So, I'm going to hold it on you for just a moment, because when we do the hyperlapse, it's going to be really fast. So, I'm going to zoom in. Thank you for whoever's watching. I don't even know. I've turned the, that's Tamika. That's your auntie.
It's
yeah. Cool, she's gone now. So I'm going to zoom in. Cool. And we are done.
Adios.